It's a mystery, and it begins like this. In Michigan, a dog owner takes her puppy, who's having diarrhea, to the vet. After talking to the owner in more detail, the vet thinks the problem could be caused by the puppy food and notifies FDA. Vet-LIRN is FDA's network of laboratories around the country. Vet-LIRN allows FDA to partner with state and university diagnostic laboratories. Vet-LIRN looks for clues to help solve mysteries of animal illness that could be related to animal food. It's easy to work with Vet-LIRN. Here's how it works. You or your veterinarian submits an adverse event report. That's a report of a bad reaction to FDA. You can do that online, search, report a pet food problem to FDA. Or by telephone. If you are the pet owner, Vet-LIRN may ask for a description of your animal's symptoms after eating the food, the product name, lot code, and expiration date, when the illness occurred and how soon after eating, your veterinarian's contact information. If you are the animal's veterinarian, Vet-LIRN may ask for the animal's full medical records, permission to contact the animal's owner. In this case of the puppy, Vet-LIRN contacted the owner and asked some follow-up questions. They also talked to her vet and asked for the pup's medical records. They tested a stool sample and found it contained salmonella bacteria, a cause of food poisoning. In the meantime, in Arizona, a cat owner reports that his cats are sick after eating a similar cat food product. After talking to the owner and his vet, Vet-LIRN tested samples of the food and also found salmonella. Turns out, the sample from the puppy contained a very similar strain of salmonella. The puppy got salmonella from the food he was eating. So did the cats. The salmonella from both the cat and the dog food came from the same brand, made at the same plant. FDA contacted the manufacturer who recalled the contaminated products, making sure other dogs and cats stayed out of harm's way. Case closed. But some mysteries are more difficult. FDA does not refer every report to Vet-LIRN. In some cases, FDA may add it to the database and monitor future reports for similar problems, or begin regulatory actions such as inspecting manufacturers or recalling products. But if FDA thinks there's a good chance the adverse event occurred because of a food your animal ate, they may have Vet-LIRN contact you and your veterinarian for more information, just as they did with the owner and the vet of the sick puppy. It starts with a report from you or your vet. That report might help you solve your mystery. And it will add to data that may someday solve another mystery and save other animals along the way. Link in the description for more information. Please share.